Do you like moist bread? Do you like creamy cheese sautéed over nice spicy meat? We'll go to Taco Bell and get the new Naked Chicken Chupalupa for only $2.99. It's only 444 calories. You can also add beautiful sauces to make it so much more delightful. You can add chipotle sauce, nacho cheese sauce, creamy jalapeno sauce, and sticky ranch. You can also add Mexican pizza sauce. Are you on a diet? Then go make it fresco with this beautiful creation of ours. It'll subtract 100 calories and only make it 340 calories. That's like pretty good. You can also add romaine lettuce, red stripes, and potatoes. So go to Taco Bell now and get it for free. I mean $2.99.
Off your couch now.
Penelope Pearson of the BBC, and I'm here today with Dr. Riley Lopez, the founder of the Antibiotic Resistance Prevention Foundation. She will be talking to us today about her organization and its mission that she is working to fulfill with the help of her colleagues, Tyler Legnon, Ebony Telford, and Gianna Heber. So Riley, tell us a little bit about your organization.
Well, we at the A.R.P. Foundation aim to educate the public on the dangers of using antibiotics in excessive amounts. Let me start by telling you that antibiotics are used to fight bacteria that cause infection. Mm-hmm. But over time, these bacteria change their molecular structure in order to stay alive. They either change their outer layer or completely neutralize the antibiotic, which renders them essentially useless. When this happens, bacteria will be able to multiply faster than it can be killed and will turn a treatable illness like pneumonia into a malignant, deadly disease that can kill millions. By educating the public on this topic, we will be saving millions of lives.
Wow, that's great. That's a lot of lives. What made you interested in pursuing this line of work?
Well, my parents always wanted me to go into the medical field, but I was never really interested. It wasn't until my cousin died from a urinary tract infection that I realized I wanted to make a difference in the world. Because you see, my cousin would always take the antibiotics whenever he was sick, even if he just had a sniffly nose or a cough. So when he found out he had a UTI and started seeking treatments for it, he found out that none of the antibiotics available to him worked because of a lifetime of abuse of antibiotics. Mm-hmm. That's when I knew I had to make it my life's work to make sure no one suffered similar fates.
Wow. One time I caught a cold from my sister and it sucked. I had to miss a week of work. I was just at home coughing. I cough so much, I have sick abs now. Sick abs, okay. Mm-hmm. Anyway. How did you get the organization running?
I'm not gonna lie to you, Penelope. It was not easy. Oof. Man, I had no idea how expensive it would be to kickstart a nonprofit organization like this. I had to sell my car, all of my belongings. Wow. Then I sold my house. And for the longest time, I was living in my parents' basement. Every morning, they wake me up and they'd be like, hey, get up, it's morning, go get yourself to work. I'm like, oh my gosh, I gotta move out. Finally, I kickstarted it though. Because of the help with you guys here at the BBC. You let my advertisement play in between segments.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome. Are the rumors true that you're trying a new approach to spreading awareness this year?
Yes, this year we're trying to spread more awareness to the younger generations. So we've been going to schools, youth groups, all not just around the community, but all around the country, and maybe, hopefully, even eventually, we could go globally.
Wow, how can people get involved?
Well, donating really helps, mm-hmm. but if people actually want to be involved in spreading the awareness while on payroll, they can contact me at RileyLopez@nodrugsforbugs.org or come to our recruitment meeting this Saturday at our headquarters on Pasture Drive in Palo Alto, California.
What were you doing before you made the Antibiotic Resistance Prevention Foundation?
Before I created the A.R.P. Foundation, I was practicing medicine at Stanford Children's Hospital, specializing in pediatric immunology.
Wow, that's great. But I've been wondering for a while, what's the significance of your slogan, No Drugs for Bugs?
Well, since antibiotics don't work on viral infections such as colds and flus, mm-hmm. It's basically saying that not all bugs, sicknesses need drugs like antibiotics.
All right, thank you. Thank you for joining us today, but that is all the time we have. We will be right after this commercial break with Ryan Royce.
Are you sad and lonely in life? Then get on over to Taco Bell and try the new Naked Chicken Chalupa, only for $3.99. So, you got my message, huh? Here, try that. Get it with cheese, get it with steak. Get on how all supplies last. Pretty good, right? Try the new Chicken Chalupa at Taco Bell, only $3.99.
Okay, and we're back here with Ebony Telford. I hear you have a background in microbiology.
Yes, so after you sent me the...
Fascinating.
After you sent me the email in regards to this interview, I took the time to take down a few notes. So, I'm the people person for ARP, meaning I'm the public relations person. I organize the speeches and meetings with the news outlets and other media agencies. My degree in microbiology is really helpful to have, considering I spend all day with scientists and doctors.
So tell me, Ebony, why did you join ARP?
Well, Ryan, when I first heard about this organization, I thought it was just another term for LARPing, which is live action role playing. I was skeptical about it because when I attended the first meeting, I was expecting to see a bunch of men in tights waving around plastic swords, you know? But then I realized that it was an organization that raises awareness about antibiotic overuse and generally.
Security.
I soon found out that ARP is an organization that raises awareness about antibiotic overuse and genuinely wants to save lives. As soon as I realized that, I was hooked and decided to join the team.
Wow, funny story actually. I LARP back in...
How interesting. Any other questions concerning the foundation?
Oh, of course. My apologies. What do your speeches and meetings with media outlets usually consist of?
Usually I introduce what ARP does and what our goal is. I have a presentation that I show as I'm speaking to keep the audience entertained. I allow them to ask each question, as you're doing now, and answer each to the best of my ability. My main goal during these events is to influence people to join the cause and help spread the word.
Is there anything about your organization that you really take to heart?
What exactly do you mean by that?
What I mean is, there anything from your past that made you want to join?
Oh, let me tell you about this roommate I had. She was one of my good friends, and she got tetanus because she stepped on a rusty nail and was given antibiotics to stop the bacterial infection. She claimed they worked so well that she started to use them more frequently, even when she just had a scratchy throat. Eventually, she just got really sick, and when she used the antibiotics, they did nothing for her, and she had to suffer. She was really annoying. I'm not going to dive that deep into it, though. All while this was happening, she was living with me, and it was a struggle for the both of us. I never wanted to watch anyone go through what she did, and I didn't want to deal with that, so I decided to help raise awareness for problems like this. Wait a minute! Who are you?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Have you ever worked at Taco Bell? Okay, forget I said anything. I'll tell my friends.
I need the clean.
Okay.
Is this supposed to be happening?
Our armrests have been a little greasy lately.
Oh, thank you.
Sit, don't touch me.
Okay.
Sorry, that happens a lot.
It's okay.
Okay. I have one last question for you. Tell me about your background in microbiology.
Well, I didn't begin studying it until my sophomore year in college because I...
Okay, that's all the time we have for you today. We'll be right back with Brooklyn Baker interviewing someone else who thinks they're special. Is that Baker? Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Be right back.
Are you unhappy with your life? Do you need plants to brighten up your day?
I have a hack for that.
Get out of here, Henry. It's not your commercial. Well, now you can. Try Trisha and Sandra's gardening service to brighten up your day. I'm Sandra.
And I'm Trisha.
And now, you can use our easy Magic Grow plant growth formula to grow the best plants of your life and brighten up your days and your life. results for yourself right in this commercial. Wow, see that? That was like 10 seconds.
Just today.
For our lowest price of $10.99, or order now and buy two for $15.99. A great deal.
Hello and welcome back. My name is Brooklyn Baker and I'm here with one of the researchers.
And scientists.
What?
I'm one of the researchers and scientists for the Antibiotic Resistance Prevention Foundation.
Okay, I'm here with one of the researchers and scientists from the Antibiotic Resistance Prevention Foundation, Dr. Tyler Legnum. Okay, Tyler, I'm curious, how did you get into this field of work?
I took some notes if you don't mind.
Oh, sure.
My mom always told me stories about our family. One story really stuck with me. The story was about my great-great-great-grandfather in 1929. That's three greats. He worked in a music store, and one day he was polishing the brass instruments when a trumpet fell off its shelf and hit him. Quite catastrophic. A few days later, his arm started to hurt. 2 days later, he spiked a fever. The fever continued to rise. His wife was taking care of him, but nothing she did helped, so she took him to a hospital. The nurses there right away knew that they had an infection, which at the time called blood poisoning. They probably didn't say it, but they knew there was nothing they could do because the things that we use today cure infection that didn't exist yet. The first test of penicillin, the first antibiotic, was years in the future. People who got infections either got lucky and recovered, or they died. My great-great-grandfather, again, three greats, was not so lucky. He was in the hospital for a week, shaking with chills, dehydrated, and delirious, falling into a coma as his organs failed. His conditions grew so desperate that his friends and family lined up to give his blood transfusions in an attempt to dilute the infection that was flowing through his veins. Nothing worked. He died. He was 30 years old. Looking back throughout history, most people died the way my great-great-grandfather did. Most people didn't die of cancer or heart disease because they didn't live long enough to develop them. They died of injuries or infections. All of that changed when antibiotics arrived. Infections that were once a death sentence became something you recovered from in just days. And ever since, we've been living inside the glory of the wonder drugs. The story inspired me to go into antibiotics research.
That's funny. Well, not funny, but relatable. I can relate. Not the part about dying, though. It's hard. Or the part about living in, like, the 20s, did you say? I don't remember. Or the part about working in a music store. I've never done that. I've always wanted to try it, though. Sounds fun. Anyway, but it was like this crazy story, right? I was in this elevator, and it was like this girl, she like jumped out as the elevator's doors were closing. I'm like, watch out, girl, you're gonna get hit by those doors. And then she threw a pillow at me. I was like, oh my gosh, this is so crazy. What are the odds that this happened to me? I mean, to me, really? Wow. Anyway, how did you get involved with the A.R.P. Foundation?
Well, I was working on my thesis for my PhD when I was approached by the A.R.P. recruiter and was told that once I finished my PhD, I'd be guaranteed a job at Phil's Fishmar. I mean, A.R.P. Art.
Okay.
It was an opportunity I couldn't refuse. It included helping people and doing the research that I love.
How much were they paying you? I'll triple it. I'll quadruple it.
Double it, take or leave it.
Okay then.
Can I go now or?
Right. Oh, one more question.
Okay.
Where can people learn more information about
Jesus
antibiotics?
Christ. Rite Aid.
What?
You can go to our website at www.nodrugsforbugs.org/antibiotics to learn more.
Well, thank you, Tyler. That's all the time we have for this segment. We will see you in the next one with some other person. What's their name? Ellie Martinelli. Okay, bye.
Hi, I'm Henry Haxs here, and here are some life hacks. Is your golf cart stuck in the dirt or mud? Well, then just back it down the hill. You see? Are you locked in the car? Then just open the door.
It's so easy.
Are you stuck on a stump? Then just jump down.
Look at how easy that was.
Here's a good tip. Never use a pill bottle for spices, or a spice bottle for pills.
Oh no, is it too dark in here? Then just turn on the light. Right here, you idiot.
Are you stuck on a swing?
I don't know how to help you. You there! You don't need to be tainted by these people. Come on. It's in reverse. It's still in reverse.
Hello and welcome back. I'm Ellie Martinelli, no relation to the Apple Juice Company. I'm here with Dr. Gianna Herbert.
It's actually Gianna Hebert.
Oh, sorry. Gianna Hebert is the head researcher for antibiotic resistance for the Antibiotic Resistance Prevention Foundation. Gianna, what exactly is antibiotic resistance?
Well, ever since the creation of antibiotics, we've been living in a golden age of miracle drugs. But now it's coming to an end. We stand today on the brink of a post-antibiotic era. The time is upon us that a simple infection can kill once again. In fact, they already are. People are dying of infections again because of this phenomenon called antibiotic resistance. Basically, it works like this. Bacteria competes with each other for resources like food by producing lethal compounds that they direct at each other. To protect themselves, other bacteria evolve defenses against the attacks. When we first made antibiotics, we took those compounds and made our own version of them. And bacteria responded to our attacks just as they always had, by developing immunities to fight these attacks. For 70 years, we played a game of leapfrog, our drug and their resistance, and vice versa. Now the game is coming to a close and we are losing.
What are pharmaceutical companies doing about this?
Pharmaceutical companies have decided that it's in their best interest not to produce any more antibiotics. They develop a resistance too quickly, so there are infections roaming across the globe, for which out of more than 100 antibiotics available, only two drugs might work with severe side effects. One infection in particular, scientists found a single case of in North Carolina, known as KPC, which was resistant to all but two drugs. Today, that infection has spread to South America, Europe, and the Middle East, and to all but three states in the United States, excuse me. And in India, doctors found a case of an infection that was resistant to all but one drug. That infection, known as NDM, has spread from India into China, Asia, Africa, Canada, and the US. Now, these are extreme cases.
So, how do people actually die of infection?
In the United States, 50,000 people die of untreatable infections and 700,000 people worldwide. It's surprising that people don't fear the loss of antibiotic effectiveness, but the reality is that antibiotics support every part of modern life. If we lose antibiotics, we could also lose any protection for people with weakened immune systems, cancer patients, AIDS patients, transplant recipients, and premature babies. Any treatment that involves installing foreign objects into the body, stents for stroke, pumps for diabetes, dialysis, and joint replacement. Studies have shown that 1 in 6 joint replacement patients would die without antibiotics. We would probably lose surgery. Many surgeries use large dosages of antibiotics. No heart operations, no prostate biopsies. We'll have to learn that the smallest infections can be life-threatening without antibiotics. Strep throat used to cause heart failure. Skin infections led to amputations. Giving birth killed even in the cleanest hospitals. Pneumonia took 3 kids out of 10. More than everything, we will lose the confidence we have to live our everyday lives.
What do you mean by that?
If you knew that an injury could kill you, would you ride a motorcycle, bomb down a ski slope, climb a ladder to hang Christmas lights? In fact, the first person to ever receive penicillin just walked into his garden and got his eye struck by a rose thorn. His infection got so horrible, his eye oozed pus and fluids, the doctors had to remove it.
That's disgusting. Mm-hmm. Excuse me, how long do we have?
Scientists predict that if we don't get antibiotic resistance under control by 2050, the worldwide toll will be as high as 10 million deaths per year.
How did we get to this point? But all we have to look forward to is those terrifying numbers.
The difficult answer is that we did it to ourselves. Resistance is a biological process, but we sped up that process by squandering antibiotics on petty things. Penicillin was sold as an over-the-counter drug until 1950, and most antibiotics still are. But this is why I joined the A.R.P. Foundation, to spread awareness about the dark hole that we will fall into if we're not more careful with antibiotics.
Thank you, Gianna, for this insightful conversation. Where can people learn more?
You can go to our website at www.nodrugsforbugs.org/resistance.
Okay, we'll return after the sponsored message. You know what I hate? People use antibiotics when they don't have to. You know, they got a little cough, they go achoo, they go and use an antibiotic. They don't need to. What are you doing over there?
I have a cough. Hey. I need to take these antibiotics.
Is this resistance? You know what I also hate? When those bacteria in your body, they change their structures. When you take those antibiotics, every single time you take them, those bacteria change, man. They change and mess up your body. You can't use those antibiotics anymore. On the streets, when you sneeze, you gotta deal with it. Deal with it. You know, I just hate those kinds of things.
Oh my God.
Hey! What is you doing?
I'm trying to take my antibiotics.
Get those out of here! Get out of here!
Where did you come from?
Get out of this car! Get out of here, man!
That was my car.
This is my first time driving, you know? I've never driven one of these. You know what I hate? People don't know they're taking them antibiotics. It's messing them up, man. It's messing them up. Yo, man! What is you doing? What is you doing? I don't care what you do. You don't take those things. Those are bad.
I know. Crazy? It's so scary.
She's crazy.
Don't want to be calm around
her. You guys want some antibiotics?
No. The slapper is going to get you for those.
Yeah, you better run. Run.
Did somebody say antibiotics? Hey, you. Hey, kid. What are you doing with that?
I was about to take some antibiotics.
Bad for you. I don't care. Resistance, man.
Those
are
my
resistance.
Only antibiotics.
Get out of here.
Okay.
Get. Man, kids these days. You know, these antibiotics are real bad for you, man. Stop using them, you know? Resist the resistance. Oh, man.
Good evening. My name is Albatross Winwer. That is my name? Yes, it is. And welcome to the ARP special. I am sitting here with the people that make it all possible. Well, I'm not sitting here with them, but they're somewhere in the world. I don't know where. Please stop moving, cameraman. I will get you fired. Sorry. Anyway, part of the ARP Foundation, and this is the ARP special. I think I already said that. I don't remember. Anyway, there is Dr. Riley Lopez, Dr. Ebony Telford, Dr. Tyler Legdon, and Dr. Johnny Hibbert. To start us off, I have a few questions for them. With all the depletion of antibiotics, how do you expect the average people to help?
There are tons of ways you can contribute to our cause. You can start by only taking antibiotics when prescribed to you by a doctor for non-viral infections.
You can be more cautious about your usage of antibiotics too, by always throwing away the bottle after you're done using it. Never save antibiotics after you use them for the next time or just in case.
You should ask your healthcare professional about vaccines recommended to prevent yourself from getting an infection in the first place. Or ask if there's any alternatives to antibiotics that could help you.
And please, spread the word. Just like you spread that mild hot sauce on your naked chicken chalupa from Taco Bell. Only $2.99, that's how much it costs.
Fantastic. And if you would please direct your attention to the public health person, Dr. Soga Sanchez. He is the director of public health in the United States. He's here to talk to us, I guess it's about public health. We'll find out. To you, Dr. Soga? Am I saying that correctly? Oh well.
Excuse me. Hello. I'm Dr. Soga Sanchez. I'm the director of public health here in the United States. Every year, at least 2 million people in the United States become infected with bacterial infections that are resistant to antibiotics. Of those, at least 50,000 die as a result of these infections. With the help of A.R.P, A.R.P, I don't know what that stands for, and all of you, we can make a difference. We can reduce the amount of people who are affected by these bacteria.
Thank you, Dr. Sanchez. Any final words from A.R.P?
Not all bugs need drugs!
Oh, that's a great slogan. I like it very much. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next weekend when we have an intense discussion about which taco place is better, Del Taco or Taco Bell. Personally, I'm on the Taco Bell side. That one reporter, Ryan Royce, he really converted me over. But those tacos and the naked chicken chalupa, it's very good. Anyway, tweet us your vote, which taco you think is better, at the BBC. Thank you, and good night.
In 1928, the first antibiotic, penicillin, was created, but it was not introduced to the public until the 1940s, and ever since then, antibiotics have taken the world by storm, but they are not as perfect as we think they are.
I'm Dr. Riley Lopez, founder of the Antibiotic Resistance Prevention Foundation, or ARP. And these are my colleagues, Dr. Ebony Telford, Dr. Tyler Legnon, and Dr. Gianna Hebert.
Were we supposed to wear our lab coats?
Yes.
Yeah.
We at ARP aim to educate the public on the dangers of using antibiotics in excessive amounts.
Antibiotics are used to fight infections and bacteria that causes infection. But over time, the bacteria changed their structure in order to stay alive and protect itself against the antibiotics. This in turn makes the antibiotics useless.
When this happens, bacteria can multiply faster than they can be killed and will turn treatable illnesses into malignant, deadly diseases.
By educating the public on this topic, we'll be saving millions of lives.
And there are plenty of ways to help.
You can start by joining our movement and only taking antibiotics prescribed to by a doctor for non-viral infections.
Be cautious with your antibiotic usage. Once you're done with them, throw out the container. Never save your antibiotics for next time or just in case.
You should ask your healthcare professional about vaccines recommended to prevent yourself from getting an infection in the first place.
Or ask if there are any alternatives to antibiotics that could help you.
Please spread the word.
As of 2017, 2 million people around the world have become infected with bacteria that are resistant to antibiotics. This has led to 50,000 people dying as a result of these resistant bacteria.
With your help, we can put an end to the irresponsible use of antibiotics and hopefully end the resistance of antibiotics.
So only use antibiotics when you have non-viral infections and when prescribed to you by a doctor.
And remember,
not all bugs need drugs!
Do you like chicken? Do you like chupalupas? Well, try the new naked chupalupa at Taco Bell, only for $3.99. Just kidding, $2.99. Haha, you believe that, you sucker. So get off your couch right now and go buy the new naked chicken chupalupa, only at Taco Bell, for limited time, $2.99. So, like, get off your couch right now and go buy it. Give us your money. Give Taco Bell all of your money. Do you hate your neighbor's shirtless garden gnomes? Do you not like rapid ceiling fans? Then go to Taco Bell and buy the new naked chicken chupalupa for $2.99. So get off your couch, stop staring at your TV, stop watching NCIS, and go to Taco Bell. Only 440 calories. That's like half a pound. So what are you gonna gain? Nothing, but we're gonna get your money, so that's all that matters. You can get some creamy jalapeno sauce along with some fire-roasted salsa. Also, fan favorites, nacho key sauce, pico de gallo, and red sauce. Get some reduced. I've been shot? Is that spicky? Who wrote this menu? Is that? Okay, that's spicky. I'm gonna say spicky rant. We got capotle sauce. Have, what's that bottom there, Fred? Okay, we got willed sauce. If you add make it fresco, I don't know what that is, it subtracts 100 calories. So that's only 340 calories. That's like more than a quarter of a pound that you could buy at McDonald's. But don't go to McDonald's, because don't. And don't judge a book by its cover, okay? At least that's what traditional wisdom tells us.